Hello, this is iSpark Minute. Welcome to another game development video. In this video we are going to build something like Skyrim or Oblivion. Alright, so actually let me show you a demo. Okay, the game is loading now. Alright, so here is the game, and let's walk up to the castle. You can see that it is really big. I'm going to pick up the sword here. And let's talk to these people.
It's not true what they say about you and the Dark Brotherhood, is it?
No, of course not. And here is this other guy. If we press E, we can talk to him.
Ogres have taken over the village. We are looking for a brave knight to kill the ogres. Would you accept this quest?
And I'm going to say yes. Okay, I accept the quest. And notice that now I have 5 targets remaining.
You should talk to Adrienne at the forge.
I will.
If it isn't the slayer of the Glenmoril witches, how can I assist you, companion?
I'm just gonna walk over here.
No, I remember. You're the new member of the companions.
Yeah. And you can see I'm using some Skyrim's sounds. Okay.
You should talk to Adrienne at the forge.
I will. Alright, so let's go and complete the quest. I'm going to grab a crossbow I hid here. Behind this wall. Alright, so let's retake the village. Whoa, here is the first ogre. Let's surprise him with an arrow in the eye. Just kinda cruel, but they have taken over the village, so we have to do something. Whoa, this guy has some sort of armor, so I'm gonna have to use the sword. Whoa, he means business. But he is down. Let's fight these ogres. He is out. I'm going to use my crossbow again. Right, bring it on. And he is out. Let's move on to the next target. I only have one more left. And I see him over there. It's a big guy. Alright, let's see what you're made of. Whoa, 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 whoa. Let's not get too close to him, because you can see that he's he means business. Whoa, it's quite the fighter. Let me bring out my secret weapon. And that doesn't seem to affect him much. Whoa, whoa, except for when you shoot him in the eye. Alright, so now I have to turn in.
I have completed the quest. I have killed all the ogres.
It's a long walk. And there is the castle. There's the quest giver, and that should complete my quest. Let's press E to talk to him.
Thank you, brave knight. Now we can return to our village. Here are some gold coins for your trouble.
Okay, very good.
It's not true what they say about you and the Dark Brotherhood. Is it?
No, it's the dark side. Alright, so let's have a look at the assets. I'm going to select all these objects here, and you can see that you can move this anywhere you want. Alright, you can rotate these, scale them, make it bigger, smaller. Here's another piece. You can find all these assets in the Game Guru's Fantasy Pack.
Here is the main entrance,
which is separate piece. And I made this very quickly. This took me about 20 minutes to build the whole thing, including the village. Alright, so let's have a quick look at the village. You can see that it's the same idea. I have a fence around it. I added a couple of rocks here and a shield there for some reason. Here's the village. Everyone has one of those carts, I guess, because they need wood. They didn't have electricity back then, so. And I'm not sure if they had ogres, but in this game they have ogres. You can see one of the villagers there, some sort of market, more barrels, and you can see that this is nothing fancy. It's just a simple level. Right, so let's get started. I'm gonna go to markers and let's place our player start. It's going to hit R to rotate the direction, the initial direction. And if you hit run, it's loading the level now. All right, so you can see that you can move right away. If you press spacebar, you can jump. If you press shift, you can run faster. And notice that this time we don't have the soldiers, okay? We just have an empty map. All right, so let's add a sword to the game. I'm gonna go to entries and let's add a new entry. Let's go to weapons and here is my sword. And let's place this here somewhere close to the start position. Somewhere around there. All right, let's try it out. All right, so let's walk up to the sword. And if you press E, you can pick it up. All right, so let's add one of the soldiers. I'm gonna go to add entry. All right, so here is the fantasy pack under the characters. And notice that there are a whole lot of different characters here. I'm going to use the knight. Move back a little bit. Okay, so let's make this character be able to speak. Okay, so let's select him. I'm gonna go to properties. And I'm going to change his script to speak audio. To select the first one and let's select a sound. I'm gonna go to stories and I have some Skyrim sounds here. Let's try this one here. Let's try it out. All right, so I'm going to grab the sword and let's try to sneak up behind the knight.
My cousin's out fighting dragons and what do I get? Guard duty.
Going to try again. You can see that he turns around whenever you get close.
My cousin's out fighting dragons, and what do I get? Guard duty.
And you can see that that works fine. All right, so let's add the other knight, the one that gives you the quest. Let's go to add new entry, and I'm going to select the knight. Let's rotate this. And for this to work, we need to select another object. I'm going to use this jar here. I'm going to extract it. And I'm going to press Y to turn it into a dynamic object. And let's go to properties. And let's add the kill quest script. Actually, I'm going to open this to do some editing here. Let's open the script. And I'm going to hit apply changes. Now, for this to work, we need a quest giver. And we need some targets and we don't have any targets right now, so let's go to the village and let's add some targets. All right, let's return to a new entry. Let's add an ogre. Okay, and I'm going to place them somewhere around here. I'm going to go to his properties and let's set his health to somewhere around 500. Depending on how hard you want the boss to be. Speed, I'm going to set it to 120, so he'll be a bit faster. Alright, so I'm gonna go to add new entry, and let's add more ogres. Well, orcs. And if you hold shift, you can create more than one. Let's make three of them. Now if you select the ogre, you notice that at the bottom here it has a entity number. This one is 387. This one here is 389. This one here is 391 and 388. And the quest giver, it's 355. Okay, so let's go to the script and I'm going to zoom in a little bit. And here is the number of the quest giver. Okay, so let's find out the number. He is 355. So let's change this to 355. Okay. Let's return to the village. And the main ogre is 387. Let's change that. 387. This one here is at 388. This one here is 391. And this one here is at 389. 389. I'm going to delete this one. Now, if you had more ogres to kill, you would simply have to add more lines. Okay, so I'm going to delete this one now. I'm going to save it. All right, so we're ready to test this. Let's run this. All right, so here is the game, and whoa, we forgot to set our knight to a default script. Find default. Here is, so he's not going to attack us. All right, so let's run this again. All right, so let's grab the sword and let's talk to the knight. There he is. Let's press A to talk, and let's accept the quest. And whoa, we have an error message. All right, so let's check the object where we put the script. I'm gonna go to properties. And let's make sure that we have physics off. And it's mobile, yes. And let's set this to always active. It looks like we forgot this, okay. Another thing we have to check, it's the script. Okay, so let's check that all the numbers match. The quest giver is at 355, and he is at 355. Let's go check the ogres. All right, so here is the main ogre. It's he is at 387, and we have 387. It's like playing bingo. 388. We have 388, and 391. We have 391, and he is 389, and we don't have 389. Whoa, we didn't win the lottery. Okay, so let's change this to 389. Okay, so let's save this, and let's run this again. Let's walk up to the knight. Let's press E to talk. Let's accept the quest, and this time it's showing me that we have 4 targets remaining. Okay, so let's go take care of the ogres, except for this time we don't have the crossbow. Okay, so there they are. You can change the view range of the ogres so they can see you from further away. Right now it looks like the main guy hasn't seen me. He's seen me already. We don't want to miss out on the action. Whoa. Got that one. Whoa, 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 whoa. And I forgot to set health regeneration for this. So I might actually lose this. Whoa, 16. Whoa, 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 wait a second. Okay, I'm gonna go to the start point, and I forgot to set a health regeneration for my character, okay? Let's see, it's here somewhere. Alright, so here is a regeneration, right? I'm gonna set this to 1. And regeneration speed, let's set it to somewhere around 70 or maybe 60. Let's not make it too easy. All right, so let's try this again, and maybe I should add a new weapon. Let's see, what do we have here? Let's try our crossbow, but that seems to work fine. I will use the shotguns and other things, but those weapons didn't exist in the medieval times, but again, ogres probably didn't exist. I'm saying probably. All right, so let's run this. All right, so let's pick up the weapons. Whoa, I only have one shot for my crossbow. Let's talk to this guy. Accept the quest. And let's return to the village. Now I can't use this, I only have one shot, so I better use it with the ogre. Okay, so let's try this out. Whoa. They're not easily defeated. I think he got me that time. That's the big guy there. He got me again. But this time my health regenerates. Let me try my crossbow. Oh, I missed! How can you miss, Sparky? Maybe I made him a little too strong. And he is out! Wow, good night, Sleepy. Let's return to the quest giver so we can get all the gold. Okay, so here's the quest giver, and let's talk to him. And thank you, brave knight. Now we can return to the village. Now you can add as many quests as you want. Okay, you just have to assign the quest to different people.
The Slayer of the Glenmoril Witches. How can I assist you, companion?
Also, you can see that building a game like Skyrim and Oblivion using the Game Gurus of Fantasy Pack would be extremely easy. Alright, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next video. Whoa, 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 it's right behind me there.